today was very important for an emergency project like this to get all of the partners together.
We had ADOT, the Army Corps of Engineers, ADOT's consultants, and the Navajo EPA water quality folks. What we are looking for is areas that would be considered waters of the U.S. by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. So what we have to do is identify where the waters of the U.S. are so that we can tell if this project is going to cause a discharge of dredge or fill material to those waters of the U.S. And if it is going to, then we will have to permit that through the Army Corps of Engineers and also through the Navajo Environmental Protection Agency. Part of the process to determine this waters of the United States is typically ADOT consultants come out to the site.
Here, where these two hills come together.
They survey the entire site within the project limits, and they look for any areas that might be considered a water of the U.S.
There's characteristics of an ordinary high water mark.
The boundary lines for that water of the U.S. are defined by what they call an ordinary high water mark. Whenever those dry washes get full of water, whenever it actually rains, it's where that water typically flows. They take pictures of the area and show where the water is flowing, what the water looks like upstream and downstream in the project area.
So I'm thinking go up on that terrace and check that.
They have a GPS unit and they are taking points so that they can accurately map that when they get back to the office and share that with the Army Corps of Engineers, and so that we have that in context with the rest of the design plans and the project area.
We did the delineation field work. We identified a little less than 20 drainages that we believe would be proposed as waters of the U.S. Obviously, we're still going to work with ADOT EPG and water quality specialists to get a solid proposal together for the Corps to review.
We have to explain to the Corps that we have evaluated other alternatives and show them that the one that we have chosen is going to be the least damaging to the environment, but also the most practical to build.
Usually, all these pre-development processes, it's all done on paper, done through email, electronically. But in a case like this, where it's an emergency, time is of the essence, we want this road open, it's these projects that you do want to get the people together for the Army Corps of Engineers to making sure everybody's on track, understands the scope, understands the challenges, and to keep the project on schedule.
ADOT, keeping Arizona moving.